Been enjoying meeting fans at the event.
I do. They're wonderful, friendly folks, and it's never too crazy, which is what I like. And I don't mean the people, I just mean the crowds, which is sometimes hard to do. Everyone sort of comes in at a normal pace, and everyone's basically kind of relaxed, and I like it.
The Last Starfighter is one of those films that has grown over time. People, you know, have such a fondness for it. Why do you think that is? What do you think the magic of that film was?
I think it was a good idea. Basically, I think it was a good idea, and I think it was well directed and well written. And I did my best. I thought Kathy was great. I thought Press was great. I thought Dan was great. Everybody that was in it. I don't know. I just think it's a good idea, and it had the right tone. A lot of people like that. They like the tone. And it sort of has the distinction of being the CGI, bit of a groundbreaker for the old CGI, or at least one of them, one of the very, very first ones. So a lot of people get excited about that, since that's become such a massive component of movie making nowadays.
Are there things that make you smile the most when you look back on that production now?
Well, let's see. A lot of stuff that is off camera never makes it onto the screen. And I had a great time with everybody. I liked the scenes where I was playing the beta unit, and I was like rolling around in the sleeping bag with Kathy and, you know, being a dork. Like more of a dork than most teenagers would be. That was funny. And I liked, working with Robert Preston, of course, and Kathy. I loved working with Kathy. And that's all I can... We only shot for 38 days, so it was a pretty quick shoot. And most of it was at night. So we shot, we'd show up at work at 6 o'clock, and we go home at 6 o'clock in the morning. And so, remember doing the Death Blossom and almost losing my lunch.
You've talked about Kathy quite a bit. She's sitting next to you today. How nice is it to be reunited with her today? And can you talk about why she was such a wonderful co-star to be blessed with back then?
Well, because she, her acting was so clean and simple and non, and she's a very lovely person, and so we had good chemistry on set. We didn't really know each other, so it was just fun. It was just that part of it was really easy to do, and it was a very sincere script. We didn't have to do any really goofy stuff that people have to do a lot of times. It wasn't over the top. It was just kind of, it had the right blend of comedy, I think, and sincerity. I have a good friend who said he owned the VHS, which most people saw it on VHS or DVD or, cable or something. They didn't really see it in the movie theater. And he said he was like, we'd watch it every day and build a fort, and pretend like he was like flying the thing. And I think that's probably my favorite story, or at least the first one that comes to mind.